There was once a relative of mine who owned a seminary. Seminary for girls. I had many talmidas in that seminary at that time. She had a son that was 22, 23, who wanted to get married. And they didn't bring him any shidduch. For whatever reason. One day I told the mother, I said to the mother, I said, why don't you get rid of Michelle? Let him not to feel bad. Make him feel good. Show me trying to find the Mishnah. We had him a girl. So I don't know what to read him. So you have a whole bunch of girls. You can't read him one girl from your whole school. You can't pick one for a date. For a date? No. I can't. I said, I'm very disappointed. She said, oh, why did you find him one? I said, first, I don't have a seminary. But you know what? I am going to find him one. I'm going to call my sister up, who was then in that age bracket. And I'm going to ask, you have any friends? So I went home for Yom Tov. And as we left for Yom Tov, my mother walked us out, got into our station wagon, and we pulled down the street. All of a sudden, I said, oy vey, I forgot about a name. I forgot a name. Backed up. My mother was just about in the house. I beeped the horn. I said, ma, give me one name of my sister's friends. She said, who's it for? I said, it's for this family. She said, oh, a family. I said, just give me a name. I'm trying to get him a date. That's all I need. She thought for a minute. She said, okay, I'll give you a name. Give me a name. I said, what did her parents do? I said, her parents are both public school teachers. I said, oh, no. This guy's parents are both Rosh Yeshivas and heads of seminaries. And they're both world famous. I said, oh, no, it's not going to work. I said, you know what? I'm doing it. I come back to the mother of the boy, says to me, no. Did you find something? I said, I have the name. I have the name. I give it the name of the girl. I said, look into it and get back to me. 2 weeks later, what did the parents do? I said, I'm not familiar with the parents. I never met them. I can't tell you details. You have to look into it on your own. Tell me if you're masked. Anyway, he came back there a week or two later. The Rosh Yeshiva comes back to me and he says, we're interested in the Shidduch. I said, you are? He said, yeah. I said, okay. What did the parents do? I never found out. What did the parents do? He said, oh, they own a big jewelry store in Borough Park. They're mamish, Hamish and Mention, very Hamish Mention. I said, oh, very good. Okay. Anyway, the girl, that wasn't the girl that I read to them. That wasn't the girl that I read to them. Wasn't the girl they checked out. But I read to the girl, this guy. So I set up a date. They went out one date, two dates, three dates. They ready to get engaged. And they got engaged. And they're living happily ever after. There were two girls in the Bishakov of Barpak who had the same name. Okay. And one of them was public school teachers, and one of them on the Jewish store. Then I checked out this girl. But Hashem said, I'm Mizavi Zavugim. That's not the Shidduch. The Shidduch is the other one. Now we laugh about it. And Hashem is Mizavi Zavugim. Your Hishtadlis is not worth much. Reb Shlomo Zalman Erbach, who was asked about this girl, but the Vilgoyen says, no Hishtadlis Lashav. He said, what the girl means is you should do less Hishtadlis than you do for anything else in you. Anything else. I want to see people doing that. Less Hishtadlis. Even Reb Shlomo Zalman, I want to see you follow Reb Shlomo Zalman. People think Kivin Shutra, so I can do what I want. I can't. Trust in Hashem. Hashem knows if you're a Baal Tshuva, a Baalist Tshuva. Hashem knows if you have emotional illness. Hashem knows if you have physical illness. Hashem knows if you have this. Hashem knows if you have that. If you trust in Hashem, and you don't lie, and you up front, Hashem will send you the Zivuk, HaHogin, Bishvilcha.